Charli XCX's star rose so quickly in 2014, she learned to run before she could walk. She had a thunderstorm of hits, like... I don't care, I love it. And... And of course... Since then, she's continued to make bright pop music that brings a smile to your face. I was busy thinking about boys. And fierce pop music that brings you to your feet. Let's ride, let's ride. Let's ride. But it all started in a county northeast of London when this Spice Girls and Britney Spears obsessed teenager decided to upload some songs to MySpace. So let's ride. Hi, Charli.
Hello.
How you going?
Hi.
I'm Marty.
Firm handshake, I like that.
You can read a lot from a handshake. What were you like when you were 14 and you started writing music?
A nerd. I was just a nerd, I think the reason I wanted to start writing music is because I thought it would make me cool. And then I realised that it wouldn't. Never stop, it's how we write, coming up until we die. I just wanted to express myself in as many ways as possible, but kind of didn't really have direction or know how, so it all just came out as vomit. I just wanna break the rules. I just wanna go back
to 1999. Took a ride to my old neighborhood. As teenagers, the social media apps that we had weren't the same as the ones we have now.
No.
Are the ones we have now better? Than MySpace and Bebo.
I mean, define better, you know? I'm not sure Bebo was ever that good. I was on it. I don't know if it was ever that good. I mean, it was good at the time. I remember going home and being like, oh my God, who's commented on my wall or whatever. Our social media apps might be better than the ones now just because then they're not as advanced. Mm. So they're kind of more protective in a sense.
Less intrusive.
Yeah, and less gonna ruin your life, you know.
In Australia, Instagram's been trialing no likes.
I read that. I think it's great. Likes are validation and approval, and if you take that away, then everybody's equal. So yeah, I do think it's really good.
Would you make music if...
Yeah, because I don't make music for Instagram.
Would you make music if you didn't know who was listening?
Yeah, I think I would, because my music making process is so selfish anyways. Artists are artists because they're attention seekers in some part, you know?
When perhaps you did reach a level that you'd seen your heroes reach. Did it feel the way that you thought it would?
No.
Especially in 2014.
Here with the song Fancy, with some help from Charli XCX. I'm so fancy. You were ready
now. 2014, I suppose, was a very successful year for me if you're basing success on commercial success. It was funny, I was so in it that I kind of didn't even realise it was happening, you know? It's one of those moments in life where I didn't really take a sit back and look what was happening. I was just running around from place to place, kind of doing the next thing. Even when really great things were happening, I wasn't wow, this is amazing, I love this. I was just sort of what's the next thing, you know? I think the whole thing about this industry and also being a creative person, no matter what field you're in, is you're kind of addicted to the highs, and they're so great, but they're only really that great because the lows are so low. So I think it's, you know, putting it all in perspective is really important.
That year launched Charli's pop career, but what you might not know about her is her family history. Her mother is Indian, but she was raised in Uganda during the reign of the most brutal tyrants in history, Idi Amin. Your mother, Shamira, she grew up in Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
How did her story shape your own and when you were growing up?
Maybe this is the same for a lot of kids, but you're kind of not that interested in your parents when you're younger. You know, now I realised she's a really powerful person. Her parents had to really kind of fight and look after all of their children, and you move them from Africa to the UK with money rolled up inside toothpaste tubes because they had to hide it, otherwise it would just get taken from them, you know? And yeah, their story is a really inspiring one, and it makes me realise how lucky I am.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Cheers.